surrounded by James J. Dillon, two of the Four Horsemen, and Lex Luger.
Well, as I look at the monitor, this is a good-looking picture. Lex Luger sure adds to this picture. Seems to fit right in with the Horsemen. You know, Tully Blanchard did a very nice thing last Christmas because of the great job that he said that I did for him as his administrative director last year. Gave me 25% of the stock of Tully Blanchard Enterprises, which up to that point was held solely by him. And one of the first things that I've advised Lex Luger to do is to take some of his money, and I'm guiding it towards buying some of the stock of Tully Blanchard Enterprises. A lot of things happen fast around here, and the wheels are really in motion. And Barry Windham thought he had things really going his way, and maybe he's got a matchup now. It's going to try and impress a lot of people. We want to stay here and just see what he's got.
Okay, let's go to the ring, and they're still here. And what we've got in the ring is the superstar Barry Windham, one half of the U.S. Tag Team Champions, Thunderfoot the opponent. And I tell you, wherever Barry Windham goes, he draws a crowd. The Four Horsemen have got all of their eyes on Barry Windham, Johnny.
They stay back on the set with Tony in the crowd with that staccato chant of Barry, 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 and his efforts to get the World Heavyweight Champion. And, you know, right now, I think Barry Windham is standing at the point that Ric Flair was standing at four or five years ago, right on the threshold of being the World Heavyweight Champion.
You're 100% right. We talked about it at the beginning of the program. A lot of the people that are very knowledgeable about wrestling say that this young superstar right here, Johnny, is destined to be the heavyweight champion. And I tell you, every time he gets into the ring, he shows you why.
Power slam right there. Thunderfoot now trying to fire back. Barry Windham staggered. Barry's got everything. And as we alluded to, he probably right now is the point of his career. Ric Flair was about 5 or 6 years ago, just on the threshold of getting a world. Hey, look at this move! Hey, a flying in! Complete flow by Thunderbolt, hooks the leg, we got a
win! Yes, sir, Barry Windham, who cut down Thunderfoot off of the ropes. Covered him with a press, hooked the leg away. Wait a minute now, what is he doing? He's motioning the
He's to the horseman in the back of the building. And Luger, you know, has jumped Barry Windham. Of course, so has the Four Horsemen. He's singling out somebody. Is it Luger?
Who's coming?
Wait, back here, he wants somebody.
Impressive, who he beat. Now he's trying to grab Sam Playboy challenge on Lex Luger.
I tell you what, JJ, he doesn't need any more Lex Luger. We've already seen what Lex Luger did for the Barry Windham. Barry Windham will bring up another chain. Now look what he's got out there.
Okay,
now it's a different ballgame.
There's Ric Flair to ringside.
There's Ric Flair up in the ring, Bob.
We're going to get to see it right here. Ric Flair
take a look at the final moments of what's going on.